tough to follow such a sassy lady. She knows what she's talking about. I'm still learning. But we'll see how we go. So, as Ruby was saying, I just want to talk a bit about things to consider when making some connections, especially going into the future. We're always talking about how there's more technology, it's all changing, no one really knows what's going to happen. So first of all, just the difference between connections with machines and people, because I think that's going to be an important difference, because there's going to be a lot more technology, smarter technology. At the moment I say, hey Google, when I'm at home, and it tells me what the time is, and what I've got on for the day, what the temperature's going to be. It's great, I'm really lazy as a result. Basically, what it comes down to is the connections between a machine. They usually work great, or they don't work at all. Like you plug something into your computer, it either works or it doesn't. It doesn't sort of half work. Whereas when you make a connection with someone, you don't really become best friends straight away. It takes a little while. Maybe you don't have very much in common, so no matter how hard you try, you can't become friends with them. Maybe you're not even trying to become friends. You're trying to make that connection for another reason. Who knows? Just depends on the situation. So just to give a few examples of different ways we connect with technology, but connect to other people. So this is basically how I see these networks and how they connect and what they're useful for. So first of all, Facebook. Even, I had Facebook when I was here. That's how old it is. So I think Facebook's great. I've got so many school friends on Facebook. Even a few teachers have crept in there too. And then I went to university and got all my friends from university on there as well. Then, as Ruby was saying, I've played quite a lot of goalball, which is a Paralympic sport. So there's all my goalball buddies there too, all in the one place, but I can see what's going on really quickly. Then when I've been overseas, met people overseas, I can add all those two. It's all in the one place. It's pretty good. I'm a big fan of Facebook. It has a really good use, I think. Apart from that, then there's LinkedIn, the more, I guess it's supposed to be a professional version of Facebook. But then at the same time, what's that person who makes a really fancy LinkedIn page? They're trying to really get a new job, aren't they? This is what LinkedIn is pretty much all about. You're trying to show off and be better than the rest of the crowd. So I guess LinkedIn's good if you're looking for a new job, but if I'm very happy in my current job, and I'm sure most of the people in here would be too, right? That's how it is. Things like LinkedIn, I don't see how exactly they're going to be quite as useful in making connections, because there's always a bit of a motive there behind why you're doing what you're doing. Anyway, and last of all, this is a bit of a different one. Just to mix it up a little, if you have an Instagram account, can you stand up, please? Don't be embarrassed, I don't know what Instagram is, so I don't know much about it. So, this is my very biased view. I'm not very good at connecting with Instagram because it's just all lots of pictures and videos. And it's all, you can make your pictures look funny and put a dog's head on a cow and give someone a horse's mane, or I don't know how it works, but I just don't get it. But lots of other people seem to be out, they find it fun, so yeah, that's up to them. So, like I said, connections are all different. That's probably enough about talking about the technology ones. They're repetitive after a while. So, I'll move on to establishing the human connections. So there's a few things you have to consider when you're going and making new connections, and it took me a while to learn a few of these things. Didn't learn much of it at school, didn't learn much at university. Learned a little bit at work, but it's all combined together, I guess you could say. So the first thing I would say is you have to consider the person's age when you're going to make a connection. If you want to meet your newly born cousin or a baby, someone who doesn't speak many words, of course you're going to speak to them differently. You can't ask them about what do you do during the week, because they do the same thing in the weekend as well. So it doesn't matter. But then there's you're meeting someone from an older generation. I couldn't ask someone my grandpa's age what music you're listening to. He doesn't really. that's just one of the factors. Then there's previous experience. So once you get to know a little bit about someone, that usually determines how well you can continue the building your connection. So for example, I have a friend through Golbol who has come to Australia as a refugee. That's a pretty incredible story that he has. And he connects with a lot of people just because he's done some pretty difficult things from a difficult situation. He came here by a boat, and I went and visited him when he was still in the detention centre, so that was quite an enlightening experience for me, and definitely a huge part of his life. So he's got a lot of stories. He sees things very differently, so you need to consider that when you're making a connection with him, for example. Pretty deep, I know. Next of all, there's the stereotypes. So stereotypes is an interesting one. I can't give too many examples because I might upset someone by mistake. So it's very important not to put everyone in the same class. So I'll choose Ruby, for example. She just guessed that I'd want to take the lift because we were upstairs before, but my legs are okay. Sorry, Ruby. So, I get that quite a bit. People always offer me a seat. Do you want a seat on the train or a seat on the tram? I'm fine. I've been sitting all day at work like everyone else, and I was last on the train. Don't give up your seat if you got there first. That's fair enough. So I think it's important just ask instead of assuming a stereotype, because you can get yourself into a bit of trouble, or things aren't off to a fantastic start. I try to make a bit of fun of it, because otherwise it gets a bit sad all the time. But I think stereotypes is much bigger than you might first expect. Next of all, there's the personal motivation, like I was saying before with LinkedIn. So it's quite obvious when there's one of the big bosses at work doing the rounds and saying hello to everyone. All of a sudden, people come up and start talking to them about all different kinds of work things and how excited they are, and you can just tell they're just, for want of a better word, sucking up. they don't really know the person at all. They don't really know much about much, really, but they just wanted to be known by the important person. So, who knows what it might lead to. So, definitely a bit of a motivation there from a personal point of view. And then, after you consider all those factors, there's usually a difference in your connections, whether it's from a personal level, so friends, family, cool dudes, I don't know, or then there's the people who you meet at work or school, so more the professional type ones. So the work connections, sometimes you don't have a choice. You might not like the person very much, but you might have to work with them, or they're in your class, or you're on one of those nasty group projects. I've never had a good group project, but they're so hard. So it's learning different ways how to manage those. And for example, the different ways you communicate. So I found out in my new job just recently, communicating face-to-face has so many more benefits that you forget about, just because it takes more effort. You've got to go and meet the person at the right time in the same place. Whereas you can just send an email, but people just send emails all day. It's very impersonal, and you can misinterpret things. And I think, it gets forgotten about a bit sometimes, just the face-to-face, especially with people my age or younger. So I think that's really important to keep in mind for the future, that we keep a really good balance. So then after that, from my previous job as a coach, I found a lot of that was about actually listening to the person's issues. So say if they're not doing so well at work, their boss would come to me and say, look, Sam, I've got Ruby over here. She's been here for 9 months, and it's not going great. She's trying really hard, I can tell, but she's not going to make it another 3 months. Sorry, Ruby. But that's okay, I'll go have a chat with Ruby. So you've got to be able to listen and receive as well. You can't just be sending things. I can't go over and say, Ruby, this isn't very good. You've got to really improve. You need to do this. You're not doing this very well. That's not going to work, because maybe the issue is that Ruby didn't get very good training at the time, or she was away for a bit of the training, and she just missed out on it, and just doesn't know what the actual process is, or just doesn't know the best way to do things, and because she wants to do well and doesn't want to show she doesn't know what to do, she won't tell anyone about it unless I'm going to ask her directly. So that's just one example. There's usually the other issues there as well, like maybe her boss is a tough boss. Hands up if you ever had a tough boss. It's alright, I don't like to talk about my tough boss either. So very important, if you're going to be sending things out, or you've got to be receiving as well. So it's quite a skill actually, to be able to listen to someone and not always jump in and tell them what you think, and you know what you would do in that situation. I found it's really good to just ask more questions, and then if Ruby works it out herself, she's always going to remember. She might think I'm okay, but she'll probably forget about me, that's alright. But she'll remember that she worked it out, and she'll be really happy about it, and she won't forget. So when I go away and go and help Ruby's friend, then my job's done, and it's going to stay. She's going to be fine. No need to worry. So I guess just to sum up or things to take away from my talk today. I think back to my earlier point, just about getting a balance. So I think people my age or younger, especially, it's kind of nice to put your phone away sometimes. Just go and talk to someone. Doesn't matter who it is. If I accidentally get a bit too close to someone with my trusty cane when I'm walking down the street, the young person gets really awkward and they sort of pretend that they're not there. It's a bit tricky for me. Whereas an old person or older person will say, hi, how are you going? Sorry about that. How's the weather today? Did your footy team win on the weekend? I've got plenty of things to use. So I just noticed it's a bit of a difference. So put your phone away sometimes and just have a chat with someone else, because, I think they're not doing it enough, and we're just being a bit too selective, looking at our photos and not having a proper talk to someone, which that's an oldie but a goodie. Thank you.